I'm Dr. Pawluk. This video is about taking the confusion out of getting your own PEMF system. I speak to many people about choosing a PEMF system once they decided that a PEMF system can help them. The first thing I need to know is, what are they using it for? Is it for a problem that had just begun, and is it likely to be self-limited? Or is it for a chronic problem? Is there one area involved, or are there multiple areas? Next, we consider whether it should be to treat the whole body or mostly for local problems, such as the knee, an elbow, shoulder, head, and so on. Is there electrical or magnetic sensitivity? Answers to these questions allows me to narrow down the choices. The next consideration is magnetic field intensity. Next is what frequency or frequencies may be needed. I can only give some examples in this video. More information is available in the Power Tools for Health book or on the drpawluk.com website. Most of the time, either medium or high intensities are used to resolve specific health issues. Very low intensity PEMF systems, that is those under 10 Gauss, whether local or whole body, are best for health maintenance. They can still help many problems, but are just not as effective as quickly. Whole body problems such as osteopenia or osteoporosis will require a whole body system. Whole body systems vary in intensity from under 1 Gauss to upwards of 1500 Gauss. Whole body PEMF systems under 1 Gauss can be nearly as expensive as 1000 Gauss devices, but they would be considered less likely to be effective. Superficial problems such as carpal tunnel, tennis elbow, tendonitis, bursitis, muscle strains and sprains, and even fractures of the hands and feet can be dealt with by medium intensity devices. Use 1 to 2 hours a day for 1 to several weeks. Once a problem feels better, it is not necessarily healed and treatment may need to be continued for weeks or months. Owning a PEMF system allows flexibility to set one's own schedule for self-treatment. Frequencies are most important when it comes to considerations of impact on the nervous system, particularly for reducing anxiety or stress, improving sleep, helping with sleep, alertness, the need to stimulate stem cells, and so on. That means devices that allow control over the selection of frequencies become important for these situations. Selection of frequencies is also important for people with fibromyalgia, chronic fatigue syndrome, and any treatments to the head. High-intensity PEMF systems become more important when dealing with problems deep in the body, such as in the spine, abdomen, chest, or brain. They are also more helpful in people who have limited time to be able to do their treatments. The rule of thumb is higher intensity tends to work faster and better, and often less daily treatment will be needed. I know making choices about PEMF systems that a person should get can still be very confusing to people. But this information in this video will give you some general guidelines for how devices are selected or recommended by drpawluk.com. Thank you for watching.